Annie Morris this year batted 567. He had 24 RBIs, 7 home runs. Next thing is Susie Scarborough. Susie played left field. Get down, Susie. The Best Defensive Player Award goes to Amy Morris. Next award is the Best Defensive Player Award. I'd like to award this to Jennifer Pettis, the Best Defensive Player. The Warrior Spirit Award, I award it to Susie Scarborough. Most valuable player, Amy Morris.
She's another one of the girls that we can put up on top and have her do all sorts of strange things, and she'll stay out there. Leslie Wiggum, a bass who will take Susan Henson's place when Susan graduates. Emily Ashmore and Angie Avar, who are practicing for Young Woman of the Year. Jennifer Rosser, when she's healthy, she's always out there to put on a smile. Joellen Young, who we finally taught how to get up in an extension without falling down first. Our co-captain, Jessica Singletary, she receives a commemorative plaque for all the hard work that she's done. And our captain, Susan Henson, who is also our only senior. And I'd just like to say that Susan could probably pick up this whole squad on her shoulders and twirl around. She is an outstanding bass. And for all of Susan's work, she's been a cheerleader since, you know, way before I was at Brookwood, and a cheerleader for as long as it sounds like she's been cheerleading forever. I got her this plaque that says, Susan Henson, the bass of the cheerleading squad for many years. And I think I deserve a big thing.
The Thomasville Times Enterprise annually selects an all-area football team comprised of Thomas and Grady counties. All-area is an offensive lineman, Jamie Lyons. All-area is a defensive back, Chris Prince. These three players were selected by the region coaches as worthy of all region status. I have a GISA plaque for each one of you, Gator. Congratulations, all region.
I'd like to now recognize three of our outstanding defensive players. These players were chosen by both of their teammates. The first one that I would like to recognize is a junior defensive tackle. Again, this is a play against Terrell that I remember most about him. Again, they were driving the ball down the field. We needed a big play on fourth down to try and stop them down about our 30-yard line. And they surprised us by running the blast. I say surprised us. They had been averaging out of about 40 plays per game. They ran the blast about 30 times. So it was not a tremendous surprise, but they ran blast. And I remember he split the tackle and the tight end. Got penetration in the backfield and took out the lead halfback, and the fullback fell over the pile, and the outside linebacker came up and got the tackle, and everybody was patting him on the back. I don't even remember who made the tackle. What I remember is that Andy Mackin got down there and made a pile and let him make it. Outstanding defensive player, Andy Mackin. A leading tackler, you'd think I would remember tackle, but again, it's a play I remember from him was taking out a lead back against Southwest Georgia. They were driving the ball on us quite a bit, but they were driving the ball down towards our goal lines, down on the side of the baseball field. It's fourth down and one. And of course, we again had a pretty good idea what they were going to run. They were going to run the inside isolation play with it. 195-pound tailback and 220-pound fullback and 190-pound blocking back. That's what they ran. Linemen took on a double team, made a pile, and here came our little strong inside linebacker coming up in there, and he hit him about the ankles, I think he was that high. But he took out both of the lead backs, knocked them both down. Now, unfortunately, the story doesn't have a happy ending. The back fell forward and gained yards. Somebody else came and made a tackle. But, you know, it could have been something real bad. And here's this little, strong, little 150-pounder. And he comes in and he takes him out. And that shows a tremendous amount of heart. Outstanding defensive player, Jesse Lee.
Without a doubt, lead the team in. He was all area, honorable mention, all region. And he played hurt most of the year, would have hurt me. Jamie Michaels, most outstanding. He led the team in rushing with 1,029 yards. He led the team in receiving yards with 156. And he also led the team in all-purpose yards, which is those two plus any kick return combined with 1,446 yards. We'll miss him next year. He's quite a young man. Together as that. This last young man was all region. He led the team in yards per carry average. Every time he touched the ball, he gained at least 8 yards. He led the team in yards per reception with 21.5 yards each time he caught the ball. He also led the team in scoring 60 points. Mr. Jesse Lee. That's the end of the offensive awards, but I can't leave without taking a pot shot myself at what it is about with Coach Grooms and these Swanee guys. I don't know what it is. Maybe somebody, Mr. Chipwire or Coach Sidley can tell me what it is, but since I sat on campus at Brookwood, I've been getting kneeling from him. I don't know. I guess any school that's colored as purple has got to be a little strange.
It was one of the playing positions. He decided to put it on. We did most of his skills. He was dependable, available, and a team man. A player who had the confidence of each coach. And the coaches had no problem. We should be selected for this award. Every team, regardless of the sports needs this spirit player. With Jeff Mudcat Hester.
Ohio.
This person, walking a tightrope, can look up and down at the same time, has shown he could take a punch, maybe headed for a knockout.
Gator!
We're here to recognize excellence, some of it the result of innate intelligence, some of it the result of good old-fashioned hard work. We're here to recognize excellence, students who do their best, and you challenge us all to do our best.
The winners of the prestigious Senior Athlete Award, Senior Class, is the least kept secret of any award here tonight. Would Amy Mars and Chris Prince please come forward? Amy Mars is an all-region, all-state, softball, basketball, and a member of the state track 400-meter relay team. She'll be attending Valdosta State on the basketball scholarship. Chris Prince, all-region and most valuable football player, all-region baseball, and winner of the Warrior Award at the Winnebago. Chris will be attending Mercy University. Brookwood's outstanding male and female senior athletes, 1991-1992, Amy Mars and Chris Prince.
Which simply means walk along. Don't toss the talk. This person exemplifies this to the utmost. The winner of the Fellowship of Christian Athlete Award for this year is Heather Jones.
I would like the following to also stand: Lisa Corley, Bobby Jackson, Heather Jones, Jesse Lee, and Meg Smith. These were our Science Bowl team this year, and they did quite well with the second place state trophy. Congratulations.
Honor organizations at Brookwood, the National Honor Society. First, the outgoing senior members, would you please stand? Dina Bryant, Lisa Corley, Holly Herndon, Jeff Hester, Heather Jones, Monica Nalen, Chris Prince, and Whitney White. Would you please remain standing? And now our new members, to join them, Emily.
Each year, faculty nominates that the CTV chooses a student from Brookwood to be recognized for his or her achievements. At this time, I would like all our judges, CTV student of the week, Lisa Corley, to stand and be recognized.
A portion of the graduating class is selected by their fellow seniors and by the faculty for their outstanding achievements and their outstanding leadership qualities. Please come forward and receive your certificates. This year's senior superlatives are Dina Bryant, Lisa Corley, Jeff Hester, Heather Jones, Chris Prince, and Whitney White. Congratulations.
It gives me great pleasure to honor our STAR student and our STAR teacher for the 1990-91 school year. The STAR student is selected based on the highest SAT score for the senior class. The STAR student, in turn, chooses a teacher that will become the STAR teacher. The STAR student for 1991 is Heather Jones, and the STAR teacher is Dr. Dale Gray.
Anything that you can tell me about spring break on camera that won't get you in a lot of trouble?
Censored.
It was fun, I'm assuming.
It was a good time. We had a good time.
It was great. Good time.
That's about it. That's about all we can say.
That's all you can say.
Yeah.
Worked.
Well, now that's
worked.
That's what I usually do.
Well, now we brought you all in here together because you were the co-captains of the football team, but I haven't really heard anything about football. I heard about center field in baseball, but
not much to say about it.
We had a pretty disappointing year.
Yeah, not much to tell.
Do you plan to play when you go off to, well, I know you're going to play baseball, but Chris?
I hope to play baseball, but I don't know. It all depends.
What's your most memorable experience or your most memorable thought about Brookwood? It can have to do with sports.
Miss Watson. Jordan.
What happened?
He was a culprit. Tell the story.
There's a
it's like an 80 gallon.
A 60 gallon aquarium tank.
Oh.
In the science room, and a substitute teacher was there named Miss Jordan. And we picked on her a bunch, and one day during class, we decided to siphon out. I guess they want to blame it on me. I siphoned out the fish tank onto the floor. About 60 gallons of water on the floor, and she was grading papers after school, and she stepped down into about an inch of water. And it ended up that Bobby and Chris had to clean it up. But
And so you were responsible for the death of how many fish that were in this tank?
Well,
fish survived. It was about an inch of water. They survived in the tank.
And you barely did. How about sports? Anything exciting happen in the way of sports that sticks out in your mind?
We lost the last 4 years.
That's pretty
sports
memorable.
Sports are not a pleasant
memory. We try not to remember those at Brooklyn.
Tennis is great, though.
Tennis is great, yeah. Okay. Are you planning on going?
We're hoping on getting a coach.
I think the chess team looks good, didn't
I? Yeah. Carl.
Brookwood since preschool. So, I mean, what has that been like? I mean, I guess kind of that's a difficult question. You've got nothing to compare it to, but...
They're victims.
They're victims. Made to suffer. There will be no more Miss Bennett's hands clapping.
What?
No more Miss McKinnon. Miss McKinnon, moving on a massive ship through the school, pushing her cart and screaming for everyone to move.
Well, now for Vince and for Jeff and for Tony, when you come in the ninth of the 10th grade, were you coming from, like, other communities, or were you coming from other, for, like, the city school system? Or the?
I came down here from New Jersey.
Hey, I'm from Michigan. That's why I could understand you so well.
I see.
There's a bunch of rednecks.
Well, I got down here, and it was just this little school I was going to, and... Douglas was, you know, a real smart, smart, and,
I think there's another word that went into that, wasn't it?
Smart ass. So my first week, I was kind of like, oh, this isn't going to be fun, but when everybody loosened up and got to know each other, we started to have a lot of fun, good times.
Vince, did you transfer from?
I transferred from Thomasville.
Thomasville. So how did it feel to go from being a bulldog to being a, gosh, what are the warrior?
Yeah, that's okay. We're not going to make them. Thank you, Mike.
it's a lot easier and laid back. You don't have as many restrictions as you do at public schools. And
oh, really?
No paddles and stuff like that.
Not as greasy.
Yeah. But you will have more money while you eat at a different school than you would at Brookwood.
More money? Why?
More money because you pay something like $2 for a hamburger and stuff like that.
Did you find the classes were a lot tougher?
No, they weren't tougher. I just didn't do anything.
You have to participate.
I mean, they're a lot easier to talk in. I mean, you
talk.
Can talk.
You get away with more stuff.
Yeah. It was a lot easier going. Not as much pressure.
We've got an outside agitator over here who's off camera. Last question. Well, how about you? You transferred in.
I transferred from school. The high school at my school closed down.
Wagon.
So.
Oh, wagon. That must have been traumatic.
Not really. But I came up. It takes me 45 minutes every morning to come to school. And that's just, it was all right. I didn't have any problems with it.
Well, that was either 45 minutes of preparing or sleeping, so you could have, you know, benefited either way.
I'm not. Girl, I can just get up and just go to school.
Let's think a little bit about your fondest memories when you were at Brookwood.
Oh, yeah, and Susie.
That was a
good memory.
What?
2 weeks ago.
That was a party.
A big party.
At Susie's house,
yeah. Lots of people.
She went swimming for that.
Oh, this was a party that was not announced to parents, or was it?
They won't even know, were they?
No.
Our parents knew about it.
More people showed up than what we
thought.
People
we did not know showed up.
See, it was just going to be.
Yeah.
We met a lot of new people.
Yes. Yeah. I can identify with that.
We have, but
we
have lots of friends
together.
Now. Yeah. Oh, we had a good time
together.
Yeah.
People you never saw before.
All the three of us and Chris Prince and Jesse Lee locked ourselves in a bathroom and sat there and talked for about 20 minutes.
Because we didn't know anybody.
We didn't know anybody.
Oh my goodness, where did they all come from?
We have no idea.
How about an academic memory? Any
any class?
All right.
any classes that you particularly like?
Calculus.
Calculus.
We like calculus.
Calculus was nice.
Yeah, I had someone earlier had said that advanced placement calculus, whoever taught that, oh, Dale Graham.
Dr. Graham.
Made it easy enough.
Yes. AP Biology. At the very end, we're doing dissections now, that's fun. Ooh. I enjoy that.
Well, I guess if you're going into some form of medicine, you would enjoy that.
Thank you.
lived together for 28 days, made it somehow, and I just hope that you have a great time at Barry, and I'm real excited. I'm really glad that you got the scholarship coming up, so good luck this year. Too, thank you for being such a good friend. How 7 years, wasn't it? From making me strive at my work, because knowing that you were doing so good, I wanted to get to, and setting such great example for all of us to live by too. And I know you want to be great, and just call me up when you become famous.
Sure, when I came to Brookwood and Wiggle, I assumed the name of Possum, and Sherry never called me back. Sherry was the first person. Sherry was also the first person who walked up to me in class, and they said, "I'll show you around." And it didn't take me long to realize how small Brookwood actually was. Sharon, I'm sure you'll be a great nurse. Thank you for fixing my finger when I cut it. I wish you best of luck in executive.
Well, I had Susie, and I just want to say that we've been friends for a long time. I know we've been through a lot, but we've made it through. And I hope you come see me in Lord Austin next year. And I always remember the good times we had at Fort Walton when we cast it. And I just wish you luck at I'll miss you next year, and I wish you come see me.
I'm saying farewell to a close friend, to a classmate, but hopefully hello to a future sister-in-law.
Whoa. That's heavy.
When I first came here, everybody used to pick on you, and you never played football with us or anything. But I really admire you for sticking it out and not quitting. You know, watched you play basketball, and you really become a great player. Been a good friend.
There's not too much I can say about Jamie. Jamie is quiet, but at that exact moment, something always pops out of his mouth that brings it. When you're least expecting it, here it comes, and it's usually more than anyone can handle. Jamie hasn't been around on the weekends. He hasn't been out at our parties or whatever. He's been working really hard, which I admire. I don't have a job or whatever, but you work very hard. You work very hard for what you do, and I respect that. I'm fully calm. Not exactly on time. Cool, kind of miss that every once in a while. You're a hard worker. Player in sports and a good friend too. You're always interesting. Yeah, right.
We almost lost this boy in a raid twice. Two wrecks, several cars. And one of my biggest accomplishments is getting through Brookwood with all your crap. Through prom, and all your taking over and directing traffic. And I hope you do well in life, because I don't want to hear your complaints. But he's been a good friend, man.
Chris has always been there for me. He basically knows everything about me. Probably knows more about me than I know about myself. He's been a great friend to everybody. I remember during football, maybe run an option and she'd get killed and make it look special. Yeah, it's always fun. Jump out of water. I love you, buddy. We're going to have some more
fun. Hi, Geraldine. And I just want to thank you for coming all the way from France to add color to this class. And you've been a wonderful friend. And I hope you can all keep in touch.
Daniel.
I had Gator. Being born on the same day, we've been always been close since he came in the last part of ninth grade year. Been running mates together. Been a good time. I love you, Bill.
Friend to talk to, and I'm gonna miss you, buddy.
I love you, and I look up for you for being as smart as you are. And it comes easy to you, but you know it doesn't to me. But you've always been willing to help me anytime that I needed you, and I always know that if I need somebody to pray with, I think I'm okay. That's better. But I love you so much because you're my friend and I can talk about Donald to you and you don't make me hush. And I love you for that, and I thank you for being that friend to me that I need. And when we compare our guys, that's really fun. And then y'all understand that. Wanted to talk about the guys and all kinds of stuff like that, and it's always been fun.
remember riding in the MD when we were in free first and letting our hair blow through the wind. It's true. You've always been here. Chris, you're a great pal. I could always come to you whenever I want advice. And like Adam said, you're a friend to everybody. You know, that's a special quality that not many people have. And I appreciate that. Anthony, ever since Donald told you about the black olives, that's an inside thing. Not many people know that Vincent, Vincent's going to keep his mouth shut. ever since that, I think we've really come around, and I really appreciate Donald saying that because I wanted to get to know you better, and then I got that chance too. And like when we were sitting there in the library, we always got to talk, and it was real neat, you know, getting to talk to Anthony, and you've really got some special qualities about him. Vincent, I think that you're one of the luckiest guys in the whole world. I really do, because you've lived through so much. And I admire you for being strong through everything that you've been through. And I'm so glad that you came to Brookwood and that I got to know you, and I know that you're going to really make something out of your life. Jamie, you're a great friend. You're cute as ever. you're sweet, just like Chris. You love everybody. You're shy, and you don't talk much, but whenever you do, it's always something special that you have to say. Bobby, you bugged me to death my whole life. But then whenever you're alone with me and stuff, and like we talk, like we talk on the stage and stuff, you're always so sweet. And you're always willing to help. And you always want me to help you with ethics. And that makes me feel good. And, I really appreciate you being my friend. Whitney, I've gone to school with you since pre-first. And I love you so much. You'll always be my friend. And not much you can say to Whitney. She's just my buddy, she's my pal, and you always will be. Thanks for supporting me through everything that you do. Dina, I know I never called you possum, because I'm surprised people didn't call me possum. It was when you came that kind of stopped. But now I admire you for everything that you do. You're a great yearbook editor, and I really appreciate you. I love you. Jesse, you're my pal and my friend, and I wish you the best of luck in the Navy, and I know that you're going to make every goal that you set in life. And thanks for pulling through history with me. I'm glad somebody's down there with me. I think you're the funniest guy that I know. You make friends just like I eat salt. And that's pretty bad. but I think you're a great guy, and you get along with everybody, and that's like Chris. That's a great quality that not many people have, and I really admire you for that. Douglas, we've gone to school since spring first, you know, forever, and like, I remember when we used to play at your house in free first and eat hot dogs and go up in the treehouse and play with the walkie-talkies and stuff like that. But then whenever I was growing up, you always picked on me. But then this year, you've been just the greatest friend ever to me. I really appreciate that. Lisa, I've already said bye to you, but I really wish you the best of luck. And I know that you're gonna succeed in life. I really know you are. Coach Massey, you're wonderful. You really are. You're a great friend. Whenever I got aggravated with Ms. Trisman, I could always come to you. And I really appreciate that. You're a great friend. Mr. Johnson, thank you for having me at Brookwood. I appreciate all that Brookwood has done for me. It's been a wonderful experience. Ms. Trisman, your mom. You're my mom. And I love you with all my heart. And I know I can always come back. Geraldine. You're crying. I love you. I can always count on you. And when you came, I was just like, I never thought that we'd be able to communicate the way we do now, because we always had the dictionary right there in front of us.
But now we can talk and we really have a good time. And like when I gave you that gift for graduation, I thought about how you had so many friends in France and how you had the courage to come over here and be open enough to make friends with each one of us with all the different personalities. I really admire you for that. I think that you're a great friend.
Elizabeth Coral. I want to thank you very much for turning my life around.
Amen.
Thank you, Lisa.
Thank you for quieting me down. Thank you for helping me through school, and helping me to bring up my grades so much.
Yeah.
Getting through school. And most of all, thank you for being you. I love you very much. You're very special. Everybody in here, thanks for being a friend. I miss everybody. And I hope that when we come back, we see each other again. And
if we don't drown in these tears.
And we all will see each other again. We've all been a great class.
We went through some hard times. And the past couple of years, most of you know, I've been through some really hard times. And there's one person that I'll always be there for you, and that's Jesus Christ. If you always keep him first in your life, strive for that, try to walk the life of Jesus, he'll take care of it. He loves every one of us. Want anything. We'll stick with him and make it through everything. So, when you're faced with something you don't think you can deal with, just look to him. He'll just take care of it. I promise.
I don't know what Brookwood's going to be like without you. When Mr. Massey and I go in the morning and we won't have you there, it's going to feel extremely strange. I know I'm probably the worst one. I'm as bad as Jamie about getting your homeroom. But thank heavens we have Mr. Massey, who loves to get there at 7:30 in the morning and open the door. You all have absolutely been wonderful. I do admit that when you were first given to me, I looked at Mr. Johnson and I said, please don't do this to me. But each one of you is special to me. Each one of you has so many good qualities. And I just want to thank you for being you and for giving me 3 really happy years with you. Thank you.
I wish you all best of luck, and I hope that you all succeed at what your goal in life should be. Some of you have decided at this point what you want to do, and you may discover that's not your calling in life. If you get involved into something, into your major, and you decide that maybe this isn't what you want to do, by all means, change. Don't try to please someone else. Because if you do, you may find yourself unhappy. So don't be afraid to change. Don't be afraid to chase what you really want. To go after the gold ring. And I hope you all, the utmost happiness, and that you all will succeed. And I don't know what else to say except goodbye, and I hope to see you again in 10 years.
Sorry, but I forgot three very, very, very special people to me. I'm sorry. After these three, I promise I will not speak again. First of all, Cody, who with him we came through a couple of really hard years, and he was strong, and he's gone on with his life, and I really admire him for all that he's been through and has survived it. And I'll always appreciate him being that special friend that I needed during our sad time. Number two is Daniel. Not many people realize this about Daniel, but he's a really good guy. And he cares about everything he does. And one of the reasons that he's not here tonight is because he was afraid he would not be accepted because of all that's happened. But y'all, he's my best friend. And I know he's a lot of yours too. He loves every one of you, and I think that each one of you owe him something. Because, I mean, if he would do anything for y'all. So if y'all see, let him know you love him, and if you don't reject him because of everything that's happened. And the third person is the reason that this room right here is the boys and girls are together. I don't know how you say it, but the boys and girls are together. That person brought joy in each one of our lives. And it brought us pain at one time. But then we realized that that person's in heaven and we love him so much. But if he had not died, Tommy would be graduating with us on Sunday night. And, you know, it's sad to say, but I thank Tommy for being the person that he was, because I promise, if y'all remember, before we left for Thanksgiving in our ninth grade year, the boys and the girls in this class were so separated, and I know a lot of y'all know that, but then when we came back, everybody was best friends. You know, when something good always happens in a bad situation. But I know God is taking care of each one of us. And God's going to take care of Tommy's parents. You know, and God loves Tommy. And God loves all of us. And so, you know, I know it's hard for the Stones. But, you know, they have to get on with their lives. And so do we. And so I think we all need to say goodbye to Tommy, especially me, because, you know, I'll sit down, you know, and sometimes I'll just start thinking about him, you know, and he was such a good friend to me, because, you know, he was always slow, just like I was, because that gave us that little understanding with each other that we had, and so I thank Tommy tonight for bringing this class together, and for being the person that he was.
Every senior since 1974 that graduated from Brookwood has been special, and you're no exception, as an individual or as a class. And you have a lot to be proud of. This class, you have the highest SAT average of any class we've had. We've got people in here that are going to places on scholarship. We've got people that are going to help other people. We've got people that have stood up for you individually, whether you know it or not. Your classmates have come into my office and talked and really been advocates for many of you and your claims. And so you have a partnership there that's unique, and I think that's just been displayed here by every one of you and what you've said to one another. So don't ever lose that relationship with one another, and strive for the best possible life that you can strive for. Do not choose anything second best.
because every one of you in here, I underline every one, you have the ability to do what you want to do. And the world's waiting for you. Now just set it on fire. And good luck to all of you. And God bless you too.
I think tonight's probably going to be one of
tonight
the special
was,
memories.
Yeah,
it's
not special. Yeah. It did, yeah. Really was. You know, some of the folks that you wouldn't think would get emotional got emotional.
Yeah, I think the cameraman was one of them.
Oh, really? Look at that. Over there, not behind. What you got to say, Carter?
No, I don't have anything to say except that it I thought was a very special, very important scene in there. Sharon really, I think, touched something in everybody.
Yeah. You know, because we've all become, you know, it's like we're one big family. I mean, it really is, because I don't think we realized how close we were to each other until we went in there tonight.
Yeah.
And had to look in someone's face, you know, and say, it's been fun, goodbye, you know. It didn't really hit until tonight.
Yeah.
Yeah.
come on. Here we go. Come on. Here we go. Come on. I'm a stone cold gentleman, but I don't like the girl that tries to get too high. Remember that day I spoke to you before?
Touch this. Yeah, that's how we living and you know. Can't touch this. Look at my eyes, man. Can't touch this. Yo, let me bust the funky lyrics. Can't touch this. Fresh new kicks and bands. You got it like that. Now you know you want to dance. So move out of your seat and get a fly girl and catch this beat while it's rolling. Hold on. Pump a little bit and let the noise go on like that. Like that. Pull a little bit and fall on back. Let them know that you're too much. And this is a beat they can't touch.
You want it, you can do it.
good to me. You know you make me wanna shout, lift my head up and shout, throw my head back and shout. Come on now, shout, come on now, shout, come on now, shout, come on now, shout. Take it easy, shout, take it easy, shout, take it easy, shout, take it easy, shout. A little bit fucking now, shout, 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 a little bit fucking now.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. As president of student government, and on behalf of our class, the class of 1991, I would like to welcome all of you to the beautiful Thomasville Cultural Center for Brookwood School's 18th commencement ceremony. Tonight, I have the honor of extending a sincere thank you to those very deserving people who have made graduation possible not only this year, but every year. First and foremost, I would like to thank the Brookwood Board of Directors and Board of Trustees. These people have been the driving force in molding Brookwood into the highly respected independent school that it is today. It only takes one look at the present campus to realize the continuing effects and changes that the Board of Directors and Board of Trustees have on this fine institution. Our class would also like to thank the administration and faculty. They have always shown a deep concern for each and every student's well-being and for his growth, not only as a student, but as a person. The faculty and administration have provided us with a priceless education and set of moral values that will carry us far beyond our college experience through the rest of our lives. I would now like to address two very special groups of people here tonight. I would first like to thank all of our parents. Our mothers and fathers have stood behind us through all 12 years of our school career, and they, when we had doubts in ourselves, never doubted us for a minute. They have been so supportive in all our endeavors, from our sports careers and extracurricular activities to our quest for excellence in academics. Without our parents being the firm foundation of our lives, we could not have continued building toward a solid future. There is no way that we can thank you for the love and devotion that you have exhibited through the years, but we do hope that our future successes will in some small way repay you for all the effort and the time that you have expended in our behalf. My final remarks I would like to address to my fellow classmates. These 22 people, each in his or her own special way, have become a part of my life, and I have become a part of theirs. Due to the size of Brookwood, our small class of 23 students have become much more than just high school comrades and companions. We have become family. We've shared some great times together, such as the construction of the junior-senior prom last year, and we've shared some tough times together as family. We lost a very dear member of our family in the ninth grade. The loss of Tommy taught our class a very valuable lesson, that life is too short and precious to spend it feuding and quarreling. We realized that our life is just a fleeting moment and that we should make the most of it, and I feel that we have. After tonight, our high school years will be just memories. But these memories, a mixture of both extreme sadness and great joy, will be some of the best memories of my life, and I thank each and every one of you for them. I would like to close with a quotation, which I feel could be the motto of our class, the class of 1991. How many things, which for our own sake we should never do, do we perform for the sake of our friends? Thank you, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the evening.
Oh, this learning, what a thing it is, exclaims one of Shakespeare's wise characters. This thing of learning, what is it? I believe that it is acquired knowledge, wisdom, and skill. My classmates and I have spent the past 12 years of our lives expanding our minds, absorbing the knowledge, and gaining the skills which will lead to wisdom. We have spent hours studying and reading, trying to balance accounting problems, to memorize formulas for a calculus exam, or to analyze a difficult poem by Emily Dickinson. While this learning has represented pleasure for some of us, it has represented pain for others. Yet each one of us has acquired more knowledge and thus taken one step closer to wisdom. I feel that there are three main sources from which people acquire this wisdom, knowledge, and skill. The first source is study and book knowledge. The second is life experience. And the final source is advice and direction from loved ones and friends. From each of these foundations, we gain depth and another dimension to our intellect. While attending school, I've become very familiar with the first channel of learning. By studying diverse subjects and taking a wide variety of classes, I feel as though I have broadened my mind and made it open to new ideas. I've learned to memorize facts for a history test and at the same time teach my mind to solve a physics problem logically. This type of learning is extremely important and will undoubtedly help me in my future, whether at college or in my career. Yet studying is only one type of learning. Life experience is of equal importance in the development of a person's mind and actions. We have all done something that we can look back on, and with looking back, see that we would do it differently the second time. These situations teach us lessons every day. It is our responsibility to observe the lessons presented by life. Some experiences may be positive and others negative, yet each new encounter in life can be instructive. Learning does come largely from book knowledge and life experience, yet it is not complete without the direction and advice of friends and family. I know that in the past 12 years, my teachers, friends, and family have given me countless words of advice. I've listened to all of these suggestions and followed a good many of them. Even though I didn't know it at the time, their counsel has taught me how to deal with different kinds of people and situations that I have encountered. The recommendations of all of the people who have been my mentors have not only helped guide my life, but have taught me the value of loving and respecting others. Advice and direction from these people have ultimately been a source of emotional learning. As my classmates and I go our separate ways and off to college, we will each strive for a personal goal. I hope that we can remember to learn lessons from studying in books, from life experiences, and from the advice of our friends and family. I feel that if we do this, we will each be a success in our own way. Success in a career, as well as a personal life, depends upon not just how well we listen to the lessons that life has to offer, but how well we let the lessons affect our lives. Thus, as Shakespeare says, learning is a great thing. Learning is a word that represents the growth of the mind. People are continually learning throughout life. Without this expansion of the mind, the human race would not have achieved what it has. Learning is a process that continues throughout life and brings joy as well as success. Thank you.
You are here tonight to celebrate your son or daughter's graduation, your grandchild's achievement, or your brother or sister finally getting out of your house and leaving home for college. I'm here to celebrate too. I can hardly believe I'm the valedictorian of this class. I didn't get here by myself. Your graduate gave me special help. From Vincent, I learned what it means to struggle against all odds. He has taught me that life is not fair, but also that the most unfair things can work out for good. Vincent has demonstrated the nature of an unconquerable human spirit. Douglas has revealed to me that success comes to those who don't let failure and trying again. We know that Douglas will spend his $100 well, and probably quickly, which he has earned and has improved his overall GPA more than anyone else in our class. Dina has imparted hope and faith to me. Her loyalty to Mark and her enduring confidence through the Persian Gulf crisis have taught me that time and distance need not separate family and friends. Geraldine and I are from two different worlds, but we've learned that she's just French fried and I'm just Southern fried. Geraldine has taught me that people from diverse cultures with patience and understanding for one another can become close friends. Lisa's middle name should have been Joy. She has taught me to love learning. Lisa shows up every day with such immense curiosity and a hunger to learn that she inspires me anew. Sharon has given me a great gift. Through her display of childlike faith, I know she pleases our Heavenly Father. Love breaks forth in Sharon every day. We will never forget her touching farewells to us at our banquet. Jeff has provided a way for me to laugh. Through him, I have learned that a merry heart does good like a medicine. Jeff has been a tonic to my spirit. Holly has shown me the virtue of a meek and quiet spirit. Her soft answers have turned away wrath. Holly is a peacemaker. Susan has impressed me with her commitment and dedication. When I was burned out and could take cheerleading no more, Susan was right there to step in and take over. From Gator, I've acquired the understanding that though many people may run a race, only one receives the prize. Though Gator was never the biggest and not necessarily the fastest, he was a finisher. I desire also to rise to the occasion and complete the course before me. Bobby's special gift to me has been to show me that appearance and reality are often quite different. We've always kidded our class space king, but he has learned it to take it with grace and humor. We have discovered, however, that deep within, Bobby is an intelligent, creative, and trustworthy friend whom we've all grown to admire. Jesse has shown me what it means to take the risk and accept the challenge. His striving for a place among the Navy SEALs has inspired me to go for it and give life my best shot as Jesse has. Sophia has proven that even in sickness and disappointment after disappointment, there can be great victory. Sophia's courage to get on with living rather than lamenting over what could have been has taught me to forget the past and to look forward to what lies ahead. Jason has shown me meekness combined with determination. He is quiet and unassuming until it comes time to act. Then the lamb becomes a lion. He's a Superman basketball player in a Clark Kent outfit. From Anthony, I have gained the ability to relax and just be myself. He has demonstrated that a man who has many friends must himself be friendly. Anthony's simplicity and lack of arrogance are virtues for me to emulate. Jamie has proven to me what sincerity really is. Jamie is quiet, but when he speaks, people listen. I sometimes talk too much. Jamie has taught me that when you open your mouth, you just say something worth listening to. Amy works so hard on the basketball court that those around her get better. Amy's perseverance and dedication to winning are traits I desire. Monica has taught me devotion, never compromising her principles, and always standing firm for what she believes. Monica has shown me that steadfast faith is far better than gold. JP is her own person. JP's uniqueness and individuality have taught me that being different is more than okay. It's very special. To thine own self be true. From Chris, I have learned that great looking starts on the inside and works its way out. Chris has genuine grace and humility. I hope one day people will admire me for these traits. Susie enjoys life. Her smile and her sparkle are treasures beyond price. I value Susie's joy in living. Whitney has taught me to dot I's and cross T's. She has missed detail, and my helter-skelter life needs Whitney's attention of order and precision. As I said, I had special help. I'm taking part in each one of your sons and daughters off to school with me next year. I'll never forget them, and I thank you parents, you grandparents, and you brothers and sisters for these, my classmates. What you've sown into them, I've had the pleasure of reaping. Their fruit has been sweet to my lips and strength to my bones. And there yet remains one special friend that shines above all others, whom I wish to honor tonight. When I was a seventh grader, he changed my life completely. Meeting him was like moving from the dark of night into the light of day. He was like no other. His name is Jesus, and he's my reason for living. I know that through Christ, I can do all things, for he strengthens me. May God bless each of you for blessing me with these, my fellow classmates, the Brookwood Senior Class of 1991.
Dr. Charles A. McCallum, President of the University of Alabama at Birmingham. Educated in New England, where he attended Dartmouth College and Wesleyan University, he received his dental degree from Tufts University Dental College in Boston. Later, he pursued advanced training in oral and maxillofacial surgery at the University of Alabama Medical Center. He received his medical degree from the Medical College of Alabama. He served as Dean of the School of Dentistry from 1962 to 1977 and as Vice President for Health Affairs and Director of the Medical Center at the University of Alabama at Birmingham from 1977 until 1987 when he became the President of the University of Alabama. Dr. McCallum is also Professor of Dentistry at the University of Alabama School of Dentistry and Professor of Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery at the University of Alabama School of Medicine in Birmingham. As an oral and maxillofacial surgeon and as an administrator with broad experience in health and higher education, Dr. McCallum is often sought by interested national and international groups for his advice and counsel relating to his various fields of endeavor. He is a former president of three national dental organizations: the American Board of Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery, the American Association of Dental Schools, and the American Association of Oral and Maxillofacial Surgeons. Although he has extensive commitments to administration, Dr. McCallum still participates actively in teaching and patient care activities. He and his wife, Alice, have four sons. Would you please join me now in welcoming our graduation speaker, Dr. Charles McCallum.
Thank you, Whitney, for those very kind and gracious remarks. The past 24 hours have been very special to myself and I know to my wife, Alice. Coming from a small town by the name of Hazardville, and my wife coming from a small town by the name of Albertville, it's meant a great deal of us to spend these almost 24 hours with you in Thomasville, Georgia, a beautiful community, which to me represents the essence of America, the strength of America. So I want to say how deeply appreciative we are that you invited us to join you for this very important occasion in this community. Headmaster Johnson, President Crozier and members of the board of directors of Brookwood School, faculty, parents, friends, relatives, particularly the graduates of the class of 1991, I want to tell you how very pleased I am to have the opportunity to be with you tonight and to share in your sense of happiness and also in your sense of achievement. To the graduates, I extend my most sincere congratulations and good wishes for continued success, health, and happiness in the years ahead. I trust you will remember this evening and its accolades with great satisfaction. Yet with a degree of humility and a commitment to make the world better for those who will follow you, I will hope that you will value the priceless heritage of abundant opportunity. To the parents of the graduating class, may I, as a fellow citizen and parent, thank you for giving your sons and daughter the desire, the motivation, and I might add the opportunity to complete their high school education at this distinguished, outstanding institution, Brookwood School. To the teachers and administrators of Brookwood School, thank you for directing your energies, skills, and knowledge towards this goal. Your efforts are key to the success of the members of the class of 1991, and thus to the pride and gratification of their parents and loved ones. Today, education is a way of life and something we seem to take for granted. The question remains, however, has education been attained as intended by Jefferson for the preservation of the principles embedded within the Declaration of Independence? To some extent, yes. Certainly, we have a most sophisticated country, steeped in science and art, and a technology which has permitted us an easier life, a long life, and the opportunity to travel almost at will to any place in the world. But yet, there are forces which clearly undermine and erode the basic tenets upon which this country was founded. In spite of a guarantee of having 12 years of free education available to all, the number of students who fail to complete high school or college in the United States remains high when compared to other industrialized or so-called developed countries. Let's review some alarming facts. The most recent data available in 1987 indicates that in people over 25 years of age in the United States, 25% failed to complete high school, and only 20% have a college degree. In Japan, where children start an 11-month school at age 3, 99% complete high school. American high school students also rank low in international achievement tests. Among the 13 most developed countries, we rank 9th in physics, 11th in chemistry, and 13th or dead last in biology. In the 70s and 80s, the number of Americans entering graduate studies in science and engineering remained constant, while the percentage of Japanese and German students doubled. And currently, 50% of the United States doctoral degrees in engineering are obtained by foreign nationals. All of these facts would indicate that should we fail to improve our graduation rate from high school and from college, and fail to attract more students to pursue careers in mathematics and sciences, we will lose our leadership as a country. Many contend we've lost that leadership to Japan and Germany. To me, it's most reassuring as I look at the accomplishments of this graduating class with a SAT score of 1010, and recognizing that 99% of the graduates of Brookwood School go on to college. Quite an achievement. Many of you who are graduating may well plan on a career that is esoteric and highly specialized. Before you become dedicated to such highly specialized professions or vocations, however, may I urge you to first become educated broadly. Fluency in the arts, philosophy, history, logic, and the broad physical, natural, social, and behavioral sciences will better prepare you to receive information, to assess it, and make decisions which are best for this nation and, in the end, best for yourself. Finally, a liberal arts education allows you to be a more complete individual, to appreciate life to its fullest. Never let your mind be controlled by a narrow perspective. Education assures us of a livelihood, but just as importantly, it enables us to impose and imposes upon us the inherent responsibility to preserve our freedom by being informed, interested, and involved with those who represent us within our government at all levels. Would you and your 1991 graduating colleagues preserve the heritage provided by Washington, Adams, Jefferson, and other of our founding fathers for those who will follow you? I believe you will. In fact, I think you'll do a much better job than those who preceded you. Perhaps closing this little poem, which I've heard in several forms, will help you to remember that challenge. It goes like this. If you wish to enrich days and weeks, plant flowers. If you wish to enrich months and years, plant trees. But if you wish to enrich eternity, plant ideas and ideals in the minds and hearts of men and women. Again, let me congratulate you upon your graduation and wish you the very best in life. And thank you for inviting me to share this evening with you. Thank you.
Two special awards to be announced at graduation. These awards go to the two seniors who have contributed the most to all areas of school life and who have exhibited the personal character traits that exemplify the spirit of Brookwood. The Patricia James Bullock Memorial Service Award is given in memory of one of the founders of our school. Each year, the faculty and administration are privileged to honor a student we feel has rendered outstanding service to the school during his or her years at Brookwood. The student has not only been a loyal supporter of Brookwood, but has shown this devotion by a spirit of generosity and a willingness to do whatever task is at hand. There are many areas of service to the school: athletics, clubs, in-class projects, and in helping coaches, teachers, and administration. The work is usually done without reward or recognition. This annual award goes to a student who has always shown a deep love for Brookwood and an active dedication to the school. This year, it gives me great pleasure to announce our choice is Chris Prince. Headmaster's Award embodies the highest Brookwood ideals of character, service, and involvement in all aspects of school life. The senior chosen by the faculty to receive this honor is one who represents all that we hope a Brookwood student will be. Unswerving in loyalty and love for the school, involved as a leader and a member of many activities, caring and considerate of classmates and faculty, such a student possesses an enthusiasm that is contagious. The faculty has always considered the headmaster's award an unofficial thank you to the senior who has truly met our goals for our students and who has done what our alma mater encourages, lifted high the values of Brookwood School. It is my pleasure to announce the 1991 recipient of the highest award given at Brookwood, the Headmaster's Award, to Lisa Corley. Vincent Eugene Ackerman. Douglas Halderman Arnest. Dina Elaine Bryant, summa cum laude. Geraldine Veronique Callens, cum laude. Elizabeth Ann Corley, summa cum laude. Sharon Dawn Halstead. Holly Joy Herndon, magna cum laude. Jeffrey Kenyon Hester, cum laude. Susan Allison Henson. Robert Hillard Jose. Robert Wright Jackson IV. Heather Christian Jones, summa cum laude. Jesse Paul Lee. Sophia Ann Lee. Jason Neil Lewis. Norman Anthony Maxwell. John Jameson Michaels. Amy Lynn Morris. Monica Bridget Mary Nalen. Jennifer Rebecca Pavlovich. Christopher Scott Prince, cum laude. Susie Angelina Scarborough. Whitney Wade White, magna cum laude.
Again and again.
Oh, this isn't me video.
Yes.
Oh, I better be in.